Moving ahead with this evening's agenda, I would now like to introduce you to our next speaker, who will be talking about transforming the election coverage on digital. So let's welcome on stage Director Sales of Daily Hunt, Malika Kutub.
Good evening, everyone. Today I'm going to talk to you on a subject which I truly believe is the single largest opportunity in digital in India in 2019, right? But before we start, I think an interesting fact, which according to BBC, out of the 815 million voters who are registered in India, the guesstimate is that the ballot count is likely going to be higher than the 6 US presidential elections put together. So it kind of puts things into perspective that how mammoth this entire exercise of general elections, the coverage in India is going to be, right? So I'm going to take the next 15 minutes to talk about what is it that we are doing at Daily Hunt. How is it that we are going to completely transform and revolutionize the way election coverage has happened in this country so far. Before I start, I think I'd like to ask each one of you present in the room today, how many of you voted in the 2014 elections? Can we have a show of hands, please? All right, so just take a look around you, right? It's not a surprise that the fate of this general election will not be decided by people residing in the metros. It is the people coming from the tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 cities and rural India who will decide which party or parties come to power in this general elections, right? So, and at Daily Hunt, our attempt or endeavor is to ensure that these masses residing in across the length and breadth of the country take an informed decision. Yeah. So, starting with the user base and numbers. I promise you, this is the only slide in my presentation with numbers today. But if you look at it, at Daily Hunt, we're going to reach to about 50% of the first-time voter base in India, almost about 30% of the second-time voter base in the country. So what is it that we are doing to ensure that this large base of users take an informed decision, make sure that the users, they know their candidates, they know which is the party, what is their agenda, and so on and so forth. So I'll take you through the election coverage architecture on our platform, what is the kind of content that we are going to bring to these users, and more importantly, how is it that this content is going to be served to these users. These are basically the 5 principles on the basis of which we are going to design the content. So starting with live content, so we are going to have a bunch of stringer network, which I'm going to talk more about in the forthcoming slide. It is going to be interactive in nature. There is going to be a social element to it as well. The content is going to be across different formats, videos, infographics, interactive chatbots, etc. And it's going to be highly personalized and customized. So to put things into perspective, when I talk about live coverage, what is it exactly that we are trying to do on Daily Hunt? What we are going to do is have a stringer network across the length and breadth of the country, which means across 543 constituencies, we are going to have a stringer in each and every constituency, streaming content, giving us on-ground reporting in terms of who are these, what is exactly the public sentiment in a particular constituency, what is it that the user wants out of their candidates, what is it that they want out of the parties who are making these promises in the elections. So this chart kind of takes us through how the entire stringer network is going to go through the 10 centers and finally to the center in Noida, which will upload the content on the app. Please remember that this content that we are talking about is live content, not the broadcast version. So, of course, it will be moderated, but no deferment here, right? Again, the nature of content, so we are making sure that the way it is hosted on the platform, it is immersive in nature. It is, I've mentioned already, it's a streaming, it's not a broadcast, completely personalized, and in terms of who are the users, who are the content providers, ranges from studios to experts to stringers and the other aggregators. So when I talk about, you know, stringers giving us live content, how is it that it will appear on the app? So if you look at it, a user, let's say sitting out of Patna logs in at 9 o'clock, someone from Cochin logs in, someone from Jalandhar, and someone from, let's say, Ahmedabad. All these four users will see different feeds on their mobile phones. So they will have a choice to switch between different channels. They will have an opportunity to see exactly in their local area what is the kind of coverage that is happening, right? This is how the platform is going to look like. You have the option on the top menu to choose the constituency that you want to follow. We've taken into consideration a lot of user feedback and consumer insights while building this election product. So it's not just engineers sitting in a room and designing this product, but we've taken into consideration that what is it that users have not had an opportunity to see so far. So, you know, they want to see live content. They expect the platform to understand and then recommend content which they should be seeing. Audience are no longer satisfied with just one-way speeches, so we made sure that we make it interactive in nature, and we have a comment section, we have discussion forums. What is it that others are seeing on the platform, right? So trending videos as a section has also been added. Given the popularity of the press conferences and the rallies will also be hosted. So another thing to highlight is that the entire experience is going to be non-linear. And when I say non-linear, it means that when you're, let's say, watching a video where there is a debate happening in the newsroom, and it's a topic on Mamata Banerjee, for example, her picture is there in the inside. And if you click on her picture, there's an option. It doesn't necessarily have to be that after watching that video, you have to go forward and then see the next video. You click on her picture, and maybe if she's conducted a rally at that point of time, you can see the rally right there and then, right? Over and above the video content, we also have these interesting infographics and factoids, etc., which will be hosted. Again, shareable in nature. You can forward it to your friends, family members, and share it with them. Taking into consideration consumer insights, so we realize that users want to know more about their local candidates at the constituency level. How is it that, what is the kind of data that they have? So we've designed the entire app also as far as the text content is concerned accordingly. So user has an opportunity, if you look at it right here, they can pick and choose the various constituencies, 543 constituencies, who are the candidates, what is their past, their economic background, criminal record if any, and so on and so forth. So you can see it in these slides, the candidates data, state-wise data. Another ask that we got from users was that we don't want a one-way communication happening from the newsroom. I want it to be a completely personalized experience. So how is it that we do that? We've made sure that we allow the users to choose the topics that they want to follow, who are the leaders that they want to follow, and which are the sources. So at Daily Hunt, like you guys know, we are aggregators of content, about 1,500 different partners that we work with. And for elections, we've built this entire stringer network. So the users will have at their disposal, you know, at the tip of their fingers, they can pick and choose which sources do they want to follow and consume information as far as election coverage is concerned. They can search content as well. Entire controls, like I said, will be at their disposal. I'll go past these slides, and they just kind of I've summed it up in terms of the user experience. Another very important data point that, you know, all this content that I've spoken about so far, of course, lives by the philosophy of Daily Hunt, that if you're covering the length and breadth of the country in terms of content, it cannot be only in English. So we've ensured that all these formats, all these video channels, all the Stringer Network live video coverage that we are getting is in 14 different languages that the content is hosted on the app. We'll also have polls around the burning issues. And so finally, I think it's like a great combination of product and technology and content which has come together. And we are extremely excited about, you know, covering the elections on Daily Hunt and ensuring that we do it in a personalized manner which has never been done in India before. I'm hoping that you guys also come on board. If any of your brands want to partner with us, my coordinates are here. Please do reach out to us. And I'll just leave it on this note that, you know, this elections, and that's the theme that we have kept for our marketing campaign also. We are going to launch a marketing campaign which is going to focus on the fact, besides talking about the power of brand Daily Hunt, that please use your God-given intelligence, read, watch, absorb, and then decide, take an informed decision on which is the candidate that you would want to give your vote for, right? Thank you guys. You guys have been an amazing audience. And for the hands that didn't go up earlier, I'm hoping that we'll all go out and vote this time. Thank you.
Thank you.